Deep vein thrombosis, DVT. Deep vein thrombosis, DVT, happens when a blood coagulation, clots, structures in at least one of the deep veins in your body, ordinarily in your legs. Deep vein thrombosis can cause leg torment or expanding, yet additionally can happen without any side effects. You can get DVT on the off chance that you have certain ailments that influence how your blood coagulations. A blood coagulation in your legs can likewise occur in the event that you don't move for quite a while, for example, after you have a medical procedure or a mishap, when you're voyaging a significant distance, or when you're on bed rest. Deep vein thrombosis can be intense in light of the fact that blood coagulations in your veins can loosen up, travel through your circulatory system and stall out in your lungs, impeding bloodstream, aspiratory embolism. Nonetheless, pneumonic embolism can happen with no proof of DVT. At the point when DVT and aspiratory embolism happen together, it's called venous thromboembolism, VTE. Side effects. DVT signs and side effects can include expanding in the influenced leg. Once in a while, there's expanding in the two legs. Agony in your leg. The torment frequently begins in your calf and can want to squeeze or touchiness. Red or stained skin on the leg. A sensation of warmth in the influenced leg. Deep vein thrombosis can happen without perceptible indications. When to see a specialist. In the event that you foster signs or manifestations of DVT, contact your primary care physician. On the off chance that you foster signs or indications of an aspiratory embolism, PE, a dangerous inconvenience of deep vein thrombosis, look for crisis clinical assistance. The admonition signs and indications of a pneumonic embolism include abrupt windedness, chest torment or inconvenience that deteriorates when you take a deep breath or when you hack, feeling woozy or dazed, or blacking out, fast heartbeat, fast relaxing, hacking up blood. Causes. Whatever keeps your blood from streaming or coagulating typically can cause a blood coagulation. The fundamental driver of DVT are harm to a vein from a medical procedure or injury and irritation because of contamination or injury. Hazard factors. Numerous things can expand your danger of creating DVT. The more danger factors you have, the more noteworthy your danger of DVT. Hazard factors for DVT include age. Being more seasoned than 60 builds your danger of DVT, however it can happen at whatever stage in life. Sitting for extensive stretches of time, for example, when driving or flying. At the point when your legs stay still for quite a long time, your lower leg muscles don't contract. Muscle withdrawals ordinarily help blood flow. Delayed bed rest, for example, during a long clinic stay, or loss of motion. Blood clusters can shape in the calves of your legs if your lower leg muscles don't move for significant stretches. Injury or medical procedure. Injury to your veins or medical procedure can build the danger of blood clusters. Pregnancy. Pregnancy builds the pressing factor in the veins in your pelvis and legs. Ladies with an acquired thickening issue are particularly in danger. The danger of blood clumps from pregnancy can proceed for as long as about a month and a half after you have your child. Conception prevention pills, oral contraceptives, or chemical substitution treatment. Both can build your blood's capacity to clump. Being overweight or corpulent. Being overweight builds the pressing factor in the veins in your pelvis and legs. Smoking. Smoking influences blood coagulating and dissemination, which can expand your danger of DVT. Malignant growth. A few types of malignant growth increment substances in your blood that cause your blood to cluster. A few types of disease treatment likewise increment the danger of blood clumps. Cardiovascular breakdown. This builds your danger of DVT and pneumonic embolism. Since individuals with cardiovascular breakdown have restricted heart and lung work, the side effects brought about by even a little aspiratory embolism are more recognizable. Incendiary entrail infection. Entrail sicknesses, like Crohn's illness or ulcerative colitis, increment the danger of DVT. An individual or family background of DVT or PE. In the event that you or somebody in your family has had either of these, you may be at more serious danger of creating DVT. Hereditary qualities. A few groups acquire hereditary danger factors or issues, for example, factor V Leiden, that make their blood coagulation all the more without any problem. An acquired issue all alone probably won't cause blood clumps except if joined with at least one other danger factors. No realized danger factor. In some cases, a blood coagulation in a vein can happen with no clear fundamental danger factor. This is called a ridiculous VTE. Confusions. Confusions of DVT can include pneumonic embolism, PE. PE is a possibly perilous confusion related with DVT. It's anything but a vein in your lung gets hindered by a blood coagulation, clots. That movements to your lung from another piece of your body, generally your leg. Get quick clinical assistance in the event that you have signs and manifestations of PE. Unexpected windedness, chest torment while breathing in or hacking, quick breathing, fast heartbeat, feeling faint or blacking out, and hacking up blood may happen with a PE. Postphlebitic condition. Harm to your veins from the blood coagulation diminishes bloodstream in the influenced regions, causing leg torment and growing, skin staining and skin wounds. Treatment confusions. Inconveniences may result from blood thinners used to treat DVTs. Dying, drain, is a troubling result of blood thinners. Have normal blood tests while taking such drugs. Avoidance. Measures to forestall deep vein thrombosis incorporate the accompanying. Abstain from standing by. In the event that you have had a medical procedure or have been on bed rest for different reasons, attempt to get going straight away. In case you're sitting for some time, don't fold your legs, which can obstruct bloodstream. In case you're voyaging a significant distance via vehicle, stop each hour or something like that and stroll around. In case you're on a plane, stand or walk incidentally. In the event that you can't do that, activity your lower legs. Take a stab at raising and bringing down your heels while keeping your toes on the floor, then, at that point raising your toes with your heels on the floor. Try not to smoke. Smoking builds your danger of getting DVT. Exercise and deal with your weight. Corpulence is a danger factor for DVT. Standard exercise brings down your danger of blood clusters, which is particularly significant for individuals who sit a ton or travel much of the time.